We're in Sevilla for a seminar, and this is a good place to make it because we have the support from the university, and also because there is a place where there are a lot of associations of women, a lot of social movements dealing with feminism, and that's a remain of the beginning of the 20th century when Sevilla was a really polarized society and there were already many movements organizing themselves to struggle for their rights, among them women's rights, and that has remained throughout history.
Welcome to the Paraninfo, to the main central building of the University of Sevilla. I'm going to give the word to a peer advisor of EGEA, Michael Witte. Please, go on.
First, the change happens all around us, and even if we don't notice it right away. The second one is that for change to happen, one group has to be willing to be the very first ones to cross the borders and step into new territory, to open up spaces for the future to come. And the last one is that it's my generation, or all of our generation, who have to be the willing ones to cross those borders and bring the change. Our parents laid the foundation, but it's now our whole generation who has to claim equality in every part of society. And that's why I'm really happy to be here with all of you and with so many different people from so many different countries of Europe and even further to discuss this topic in the frame of geography.
The lecture's title, Geography, Gender and Space. And I will make a historical perspective from geographical thought perspective towards what has happened with gender or how gender has been introduced in geography.
Welcome to the first part of the Feminist Geography Fair as part of Write Your Role. In these events, we'll have a variation of presentations about different issues in feminist geography and scholarship.
I don't know, why are we doing that? Is that just to see?
Yeah. My lecture today was about the binary between the single and the coupled. So it was based on an empirical project I conducted in Britain, interviewing 40 single childless people.
I've been doing research on prostitution and geographies of sex work for around 20 years now. So today I tried to do a talk which was explaining why I think my work is important and why we need to study the geographies of prostitution.
I don't know if any of you have already got inside. If not, and if you have time, you should, because it's one of the... It's actually the third largest cathedral in the world. We are at the royal palaces de Alcáceres of Sevilla, which were the seat of the Castilian kings and before the Moorish kings. And this place is special because it has many historic layers that represent how history at sometimes was not a matter of clash of civilizations, but a matter of tolerance and inclusion.
Realmente estoy muy sorprendida, positivamente sorprendida, porque los participantes, las participantes que vienen de distintas formaciones disciplinarias de distintos países, su nivel intelectual, académico y de reflexión, me parece que es un nivel bastante alto. Hablaron con el corazón, hablaron desde el intelecto, de que les duele la violencia, de que hay que buscar soluciones frente a la violencia de género. Se habló de cosas muy importantes de manera muy respetuosa, se analizó los orígenes de la violencia, las consecuencias de la violencia y también posibles soluciones frente a la violencia como un fenómeno global que afecta a todas las sociedades porque todas vivimos bajo un sistema patriarcal.
I'm participating in this event because I've been interested in gender studies since the beginning of my study of human geography in Utrecht. Mainly because I felt it was not only interested to look at different gender roles in a sociological context, but also in a human geography context, and why people live in different places and why that differs per gender.
I'm participating because I think that the topic and all the problems we discuss are really important.
I organize the stuff because it is important to give all those persons who are interested in it room to discuss about it and share their opinions and learn something new about this topic.
I think it's important to have this seminar because we need to raise more awareness in EGEA for gender roles.
So I think it's not only important that the participants learn something, but that they also share and spread this knowledge. So they also, like during the seminar, we also had some time for them to create some outputs. The first output is a seminar diary. So in groups of 2, 3, even 4 persons, they write about they write a page about a half day, and we'll put all this together and spread this. Another output are the social media videos. So they got like a small video training by one of our experts, by Jin, and then they have to make themselves small videos which we'll put on YouTube.